In poor physical health, well, you might want to check your finances. Studies show there is actually a strong link between those two things. With us today is our financial expert. I'm going to call her Dr. Rose Oswald-Poles today with the Wisconsin Bankers Association. Walk us through some easy steps toward good overall financial health. You really felt like this was an important topic. You saw one of our stories earlier this week.
Right.
On how to improve, you know,
your physical health.
Our physical health.
Mm-hmm.
And there are studies linking the two.
There are. Certainly, you know, when you tend to overeat, it's because you're stressed. Well, overeating means you're spending more, either at a fast food place or at the grocery store on items you wouldn't normally buy. And that's just one symptom. I mean, depression, there's a lot of physical ailments that can be tied to just financial stress. So hopefully we'll alleviate some of those worries today.
All right. So we are talking about organization, self-control, and discipline.
Yeah, those are really the keys. When you hear financial health, a lot of people think, oh, it's just how much money do I have? But it's a lot more than that and does really require self-discipline, self-control, just like exercise does, and organization.
You have some elements that you say make up good financial health.
Yeah, the very first one is really crunch the numbers. You know, crunching in exercise is not always fun. Numbers are not always fun. But you have to start there and do
here.
That. There are. Create a spreadsheet so that you know what your income is, but also what your regular expenses are. And then track those expenses every month, update the spreadsheet accordingly, and start writing down the numbers that correlate to your short-term and your long-term financial goals.
Are you seeing more people doing this just in light of the recession?
I think people have gotten better, and because of the economy and what it has done to them financially, I think all of us have suffered. So tracking is the first key.
Okay. Build
second
good
step,
credit, right?
Yeah, build good credit, exactly. Maintain a healthy bank account is my second step. Balance your account at least monthly. You get statements mailed to you. But I really encourage you to also track that weekly. There's phone banking, online banking. You want to do that not only to record your withdrawals better, but also to just check for any unauthorized transactions. And then really take 10% of your paycheck and put it into the bank for that emergency savings fund. That is the biggest reliever for your day-to-day financial stress.
And you say put your spending on a diet.
Yeah, put your spending on a diet when necessary. You know, buy really what you need, not always what you want.
She's really working off these funds,
isn't she? I'm trying to. you know, use coupons. They're great, especially at grocery stores. You can really save some money. Make smart research decisions when you're buying bigger ticket items, certainly homes. Cars fall into those categories. And then, as we've said in the past, use those credit cards only when absolutely necessary and try and pay them off fast.
And your last point, you say retirement. Save for retirement. It's really like exercise. In what way?
The two parallels are actually really easy because retirement account, you need to save a little bit consistently. Just like exercise, you got to do at least a little bit all the time. And that will pay off for you financially in huge dividends in the future.
Rose, some great reminders. And important to point out, I mean, often the link between the two.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, there is.
Get your financial
and physical
self
fitness
back in shape.
Yep.
Thanks, Rose. Great suggestions. We'll be back in just a minute.